networking, security, and Wireshark.
I'm going to take a stab at explaining how ARP, otherwise known as the Address Resolution Protocol, works in networking using a very simple example. So to set up our scenario, we have a set of PCs here that are connected to the same network. They're physically connected to a common router or switch via Ethernet cable. This router slash switch combo is then connected out to the internet. And these devices need to communicate to one another, but also to resources outside of the network. So let's set up some definitions here before we get started. First and foremost is, what is the local network, or the commonly known as the broadcast domain? So a broadcast domain is a set of machines that are connected together on a local segment, quote unquote, or through a switch that share a common IP addressing scheme and a common subnet. The subnet being the range of IP addresses available in that network. So in this case, the subnet definition is what we know as a slash 24, but really it means that devices in this network have IP addresses in the range 192.168.0.0-255. So these devices here, physically connected to each other via a switch or a router switch combo, like your ISP modems that they provide to you, this is considered a local network and a broadcast domain. So let's also explain the difference between a MAC address and an IP address. So a MAC address is considered a physical, semi-permanent address uniquely assigned to each one of these assets. Okay? Any asset that has a network interface card or network interface adapter, whether it be a physical or a wireless, has a MAC address associated, and this MAC address should be unique to that asset, not to the type or brand. It should be unique to this actual individual device. And manufacturers of devices generate MAC addresses and associate them with the device, trying their best to be unique. There are some issues with collisions, but let's just ignore that for now. So suffice to say, each of these has its own physical MAC address that is permanently associated with this device. On top of that, at a layer above that, in the OSI model, we have IP addresses, which are not permanently assigned. IP addresses could be configured on a device manually, so we call that static assignment, or they could be dynamically assigned to it with something like DHCP, which dynamically assigns IPs to devices on the network. But IP addresses are not permanent, right? They can be changed, they can be configured either dynamically or statically. And every device on this network has an IP address. Even the router switch, it's not depicted here, but the router switch usually has an IP address of say .1. So 192.168.0.1, we call this the gateway, okay? Now here's why we need ARP. When devices are communicating to one another on the network, generally speaking, the applications that are communicating use IP addresses or host names, which are mappings to IP addresses, to communicate. Okay, whether it be a resource within the network, say 192.168.0.10 wants to communicate to .12, or say .12 wants to communicate to a server on the public internet, they do so via IP addresses. Now, IP addresses are useful when you're trying to go between networks. So again, we said this definition of these devices here connected to this router and switch are a network. But out here on the internet, there are, you know, hundreds, thousands of other networks with different IP addresses you may want to connect to. So IPs are useful for that. And that's what the job of a router is to make a decision about, okay, well, if I need to communicate with an IP, does that IP address live on this network in here? Or a network on the internet, or some other network I'm attached to? And do I need to send that data locally, or do I need to send it to another network through another interface? However, when it comes to the local network and moving data around from these devices to one another, we don't use the router. We use something known as a switch. Now, if you're in an enterprise network, we generally have routers and switches separate, or there's different functionalities on the same device that are through what we call layer 3 functionality versus layer 2 functionality. But a switch's job is to actually move traffic around the local network and to understand, you know, what device lives on this interface of the switch, what device lives on this interface, and what device lives on this interface. And what the switch will do is keep in its tables a listing of which MAC address, okay, the physical layer address, is associated with each of its interfaces. So it could say that 5E is associated with this interface, 5G is this interface, and 5F is this interface. So that's good. The switch knows which MAC addresses live on which interfaces. The router knows about the IP addresses that it may want to communicate with. So the problem, though, is that none of these devices yet know which IP address associates with each MAC address. And that's what ARP does. Because when this device needs to make a decision about traffic, it needs to know what IP address it needs to get to. And it needs to know where that IP address actually lives. Do I send that device? So if I want to get to .12, where do I send that traffic? Do I send it out this interface, or this interface? And the way that works is that the router says, well, what MAC address is associated with .12? Okay. It finds out the MAC address, and then it asks the switch, well, what interface does that MAC address live on? And it'll say 5G lives on this interface and send the traffic down here. So that, in a nutshell, is why we have MAC addresses and ARP. MAC addresses and IP addresses, and why ARP is the protocol that connects them together. It allows each of these devices individually to establish a table of mappings between IP addresses and MAC addresses so that intelligent decisions can be made about how to move traffic around a local network. Okay, so that is ARP. Let's take a minute to actually look at what ARP looks like in Wireshark. So when I pull up Wireshark, ARP is one of the simplest protocols that you can actually investigate. Take a look. The filter is just ARP in the display filter. I'm doing a wide open capture on my Ethernet adapter. And it looks something like this. You have a device sending out a broadcast to say, who has 10.0.10.43? Meaning, who has this IP address? Tell 10.0.10.5. The next message is 10.0.10.43 is at this MAC address. And so what this is effectively doing is you broadcast out a message saying, hey, who has this IP? Like, who owns this address? And he's telling everyone on the network. This is what a broadcast is. Broadcasting that message to every different device on that LAN. And then the one responsible who actually has that IP address replies back directly to 10.0.10.5 and says, hey, 10.0.10.43 is at this MAC address. I own it. So if you think about that in terms of our picture, what it looks like is this. Say 10.0.192.168.0.10 wants to communicate with 0.12. And it'll say, send out ARP broadcast to everyone saying, who has 192.168.0.12. So it'll send this out to everyone. Now, the ARP protocol works this way in that only the asset that owns that MAC address or owns that IP address should reply with its MAC address back directly to the requester. So for ARP to work, you need to make sure that this can broadcast that ARP message, the ARP request, to everything on the network. And then only that one device will respond back to the originating device, telling it what the MAC address is. And what this allows the machine to do is build its own local ARP table. So in Windows, if you want to take a look at your ARP table, you can go in and do an ARP-A. And right away, you can see all of the different mappings that your machine has developed using the ARP protocol between IP addresses and physical addresses, MAC addresses. And that's really what ARP does. That's it for this video. If you enjoyed it, please like and subscribe. And if you have any questions on the topic we've covered, please join the Discord server where we talk all things network. Until next time.